Right. So I know that you actually do not have a bank account with us. So
it's an average day for those living paycheck to paycheck, paying bills, dropping the kids off at school, and trying to hold down a job.
It's been busy at the employment center.
Yeah, we've got a full house over here.
But these people aren't really facing poverty. They're professionals, politicians, and concerned citizens eager to spend the day in the life of those struggling to make it.
The poverty simulation is actually simulating what it would be like to live in poverty for 1 month. So when we're talking about poverty with this simulation, we're not necessarily talking about somebody who's homeless or unemployed, even though there are people in the simulation experiencing those things, but we're really talking about the working poor.
So we'll have to get it checked out for you, okay?
Participants were assigned a role within a family and had to work together to survive a month in poverty.
I'm not sure.
Typically, you have to, you know, go to all the different agencies in town, pay your mortgage, get your food, buy your clothes. If you need to apply for income support, you'd go there. My brother's been pawning all our furniture so he can buy stuff. So it's just a matter of getting to all the different places.
This fast-paced simulation is a unique way of showing the struggle those in poverty face on a regular basis. With the ring of a bell, situations change and participants are thrown curveballs.
I'm a 15-year-old child, so I spend a lot of time by myself. When I get home, nobody's home. They're all out working or paying bills, and I'm by myself. And then when I was evicted, I was actually evicted while I was home alone. So that was hard.
You bounce around. I dropped out of school, so I've got myself a bit of a part-time job in a cafeteria and earning a bit of money. And I have my sister who's struggling at school, and my mom's boyfriend just left and left us with 10 bucks. So here we are, and we're trying to make the best of it.
For many participants, the simulation provided insight into life below the poverty line.
There's so little flexibility. If one little thing goes wrong, it just throws off your whole plans. At the beginning, I was making a list of all the stuff I was going to do, and then bells ring and life crises come and everything gets thrown out the window. And so it just really lets you see kind of what people are struggling with and how they have to really fight through just kind of stuff that, you know, people who aren't living in poverty can just deal with.
So it's 5%.
Okay, I'll do it.
This temporary simulation left a lasting impression.
We work with clients like this on a daily basis. Every day we see the cycle of poverty, so I mean, it really helps develop a level of empathy to understand what your clients are dealing with on a daily basis when they come to you and say, I can't pay my rent.
We want people to walk out of here today with a greater understanding of what it means to live in poverty, and even though they will be going back to their normal day-to-day lives, maybe that's going to mean that when they meet somebody on the street who's struggling, they're going to show them more compassion. Or maybe they will go and they'll start volunteering regularly or make a donation to a nonprofit or call us at United Way and ask for ways that they can work with us to end poverty in our community.
For Shaw TV, I'm Leah Caldo.